us out of the inn. My mark. Let's go. Slow.
Maybe a nice little axe. Pretty like.
Axe? Are you serious?
Why not? I'd like it.
Come on.
Grab those swords, but I prefer me trusty axe.
Amongst the living is but the wink of an eye. What's left when we are gone? How shall we be remembered? Will they speak of us with respect or disdain? Bran was a great man. We shall remember him as a hero!
Lead our ways to the
You need not do this, child.
I know. But I won't.
This madness. Such a young lass.
Erna should be the one going. They shared a bed longer.
Silence. It is her decision.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. Nice to see you again. The eulogy.
King Bran of Clan Twirsech has embarked on his final voyage. At its end, our glorious ancestors await him. Together they will hunt and raid. They will sit round the fire and praise the deeds of ages past. For now, he lives in our hearts. One day, we too shall stand at his side and face the sea together. That will be a good day.
You smell wonderful.
Geralt, we're at a funeral.
You smell wonderful at this funeral.
Skellige is its clans. In times of war, tradition holds the clans unite under the leadership of their king. We bid Bran farewell. Time to pick his successor, who will lead us against the Black Ones. The gates of Caer Troll stand open to all who hail Bran of Clan Tuilsach dear. Mead and meat will be plentiful. During the wake, those who believe themselves worthy of the crown will step forth.
Come to the wake with me.
Gladly. Feasts in Skellige, so predictable. Slobbering drunks, brazen boasting, and the inevitable rows that result.
Yeah, nothing like the banquets mages attend. Remember the one on Thanet?
You were there. How could I forget? I also remember excruciatingly well what happened after the banquet.
Reading my mind again?
What's more, I like what I see. Did you learn anything in Valen?
Valen. Awful place. Somehow Ciri wound up at the castle of the local ruler, a baron, self-proclaimed. This was after she was injured.
Injured? Was it serious?
Don't think so. Must have recovered because this baron sent her on to Novigrad. Think she was looking for you at the time. These witches Ciri came across, she was lucky to escape them.
Witches?
Creatures, more like. Can't say exactly what they are, but they're dangerous. Very. Also ran into an old friend of ours in Velen, Kira.
What on earth is Kira Metz doing in that wasteland?
Hiding from witch hunters. Listen, she told me an elven mage had been there looking for Ciri.
Good. You'll need to tell me more when we have some time.
Been to Novigrad. Ciri was there, looking for a way to lift some curse. She's not there anymore.
You're certain?
Heard it from Dandelion, with no embellishments.
Do you know any more about this curse?
Not much. Ciri ran into some trouble, never finished what she went there to do. I recovered a phylactery. She was looking for a way to enchant it.
I'll look at it later.
How about you? What have you learned?
Something strange happened on Ard Skellig a time ago. A disaster brought about by a burst of magic. Extraordinary, really. Natural anomaly. Never seen anything like it. My intuition tells me Syria was its cause.
As much as I respect your intuition, Yen, we need something specific. Evidence.
I'd know for certain if I was able to inspect the disaster zone. Unfortunately, Ermion and his druids aren't letting anyone near.
Ermion's head of the Skellige Circle. Haven't seen him since...
Since Ciri was a little girl. I doubt he'll do you any favors, not even for old time's sake.
So why won't Ermion let you inspect the area of the anomaly?
Call it a difference of opinion. A large, loud difference. Look, it's Krach.
White Wolf!
Greetings, Krach.
I shall see you at the wake, and I'll not accept any excuses. I've an important matter to discuss with you.
I shall wear black and white for the feast. I count on you to don something complimentary. Something that doesn't reek of a thousand hunts.
Yen, you know I can't stand new doublets. Just too tight till you break them in.
And just like Quark, I'll not accept any excuses. We're not here to enjoy ourselves. We've matters to resolve and should dress appropriately. I've rented a room at the inn. Took the liberty of laying out some clothes for you there. You ought to go. Choose something. In the meantime, I have something to attend to. We'll meet at the entrance to the feast hall.
Such thing as bad
the
ships
plan?
Or bad
ships. Well, my dad's off fighting the blood.
River, don't eat so much.
Why the spit not?
Because if you get hit in the gut and those herrings get tangled in your entry, or
being
no hope
for
you. You heard the young man Bates sailed off to face the bank.
Hey, what about the people asking for more winners?
Outlanders are welcome to try too. Glory and honor reign every which way.
Stuffed unicorn. She fixed it. No idea how she managed to bring so much clothing. Must have hired out a galleon. As usual, black and white. Glamour. Scent of lilac and gooseberries, even with the lid on. Taste hasn't changed. DeVries, the poisons. Still turns to it for inspiration. Scope. Guess she never goes anywhere without it. As Philippa Eilhart said, megascopes and toothbrushes, deeply personal possessions. Not something I'd ever wear. But what don't we do for our... Who exactly is she to me? Greetings.
Smooth seas this morn. As if the gods themselves were paying their respects to the great Conan Bran.
You a tailor?
I am. Only one in the Isles, most like.
Take it you're good with scissors. Give me a haircut.
It ain't something I usually do. But it wouldn't be right to turn down a traveler.
So long.
Swords, but I prefer my trusty axe.
Think you could take him, eh?
I'm weary of you.
Thank you.
weapon.
Bran was a great ruler.
He needs a worthy successor.
You speak as though you have someone in mind.
Skellige's troubles very much derive from it not being a hereditary monarchy. Any upstart can be king and destroy his predecessor's legacy.
The King of the Isles is a more symbolic position.
That should change as well. A strong leader who wields true power. That is what the times require.
Introduce me.
This is my friend Geralt, and this is Berna, widow of the dear departed Bran.
The Queen Mother. It's a pleasure to meet you, Geralt. You must forgive me. But on a day like today, I'm afraid I cannot indulge in my penchant for long conversations.
I can see you chose your own outfit. You know, of course, that together we look about as good as lace frills on a battle axe.
Everyone's got their style. Don't like funerals. Don't like feasts.
I know. You also dislike underdone meat and being teleported. But sometimes we must overcome our disgusts and prevail.
We should mingle before they all get drunk. There'll be no talking to anyone then.
Good thinking. I don't know what Krach wants, but when we meet with him, we should have clear minds.
I'm not gonna drink. I dull my senses when I'm in such pleasant company.
Do you plan to compliment me all evening?
I plan to tell you what I think.
That summer knives are good for picking your teeth, Jack. Axe. There's a weapon.
So, what have you brought for the farewell feast?
Bread, sheep's milk, cheese.
Our wagon's full of loot to be ripped from the bad ones.
Geralt, there's something I've been meaning to ask you. Your beard. Why did you decide to grow it out?
Don't really know.
Must say it suits you.
As strong as he looks.
Lady Yennefer. Sir.
Greetings, Arnvald. My companion is Geralt of Rivia.
I am honored.
Nice to meet you too. Quite a few guests.
They come to bid their king farewell. They come to see the claimants to the crown.
We wanted to talk to Krach on Crate.
The Jarl will join us shortly. He's assigned you a place of honor at the table just beside his daughter Ceres. Follow me, please.
They've seated us here.
I asked them to. Wanted to meet the notorious Witcher Geralt.
We've met. Don't remember?
That was ages ago. Yammer and I were children when you last visited Orda. But you should meet your feast mates and learn me the dubious honor. That's Halbjorn, son of Holger Blackhand, Blue Boy Lucas, Madman Lucas's firstborn, and choking down a stockfish over there is Otric on Hindar.
Seems they set us with the sons of Jarls exclusively.
Sarazon Freyd is the daughter of a Jarl Geralt. Jarl's daughters are in no way inferior to their sons.
Do you know every last one of them dreams of being Bran's successor? Look at him. Likely not.
Sarazon is jealous, for the one among us who performs the greatest feat will be crowned king.
We all know the feats are a sideshow. Our fathers will choose who will wear the crown. What do you think they spoke to that about?
You talk like that because you're short of strength and skill. Remember when Hjalmar challenged us all to a race up the mount? You didn't stand with us then. As he buried his axe in that stump at the top to mark his victory, you were warming your chicken bones by the fire.
Had my reasons for not participating, but I would have won then, as I'd win now.
Now you mention him. Just noticed Hjalmar's not here.
My brother walks his own paths. But about the race, why don't we repeat it? I'm willing to challenge any of you, Witcher included. If I beat him to the top, venture to say that'll be a feat, eh? So you in?
If the Witcher's in.
Geralt?
Gladly. What are the rules?
Whoever pulls Hjalmar's axe from the stump at the top of the hill wins. Stray off the path and you lose.
And here I was, ready to puke from all the boredom. Let's go! We're here. From this spot, you must reach the top of that mount. At the summit, you'll see the stump of an oak, Hjalmar's axe buried in it. Whoever pulls the axe from the stump first wins.
I'm ready.
You'll start when I sound the horn.
Behold, Hjalmar's axe! I beat the famous White Wolf!
Congratulations.
Let's go back.
Be glad to tell everyone about your victory. See the wakes in full swing.
Lost sight of yous. Who won?
Ceres, proving she's her brother Hjalmar's equal in every way. She retrieved the axe from the cliff.
Cannot be.
Now I know why Hjalmar named you Sparrowhawk.
Enough of the natter and let's drink.
To Ceres.
Pass the mead in a tankard for the man.
To Bran. May he want for nothing in the world beyond.
Beautiful companion.
You've been great company. Sadly, it's time we moved on.
Really?
Indeed. We must talk, but not here. You shall learn all beyond that door.
I
past the lands of Gus has gone completely mad. He's raised Dunar's magic.
Why would I?
The Queen should join her men on his last journey. Tradition
to win without the beasts.
Geralt, this is Holger Blackhand, Verna, Bram's widow, and our hostess today. You've already met.
Widow? A widow's duty is to lie beside her husband.
A widow's duty is to care for the king's son.
Not by our customs, it ain't.
Your customs are barbarous.
Not our place to criticize, Yen. All peoples do things their own way.
We're talking about the self-immolation of women, not about decorating trees for Yule.
Harsh custom, but this is a harsh land. Tradition is Skellige's backbone.
People make laws, and people can change them.
Heard a lot of good things about Bran.
I will miss him sorely. I was not his first wife, but I bore him his firstborn son, and saw him off on his final journey. We lived a great many years together.
Let's move on, Yen.
High time we did as well. Come, Svanriga.
Vern is a scheming whore. Refuses to admit her ring's ended. Bran knew how to keep her in line. Let's drink to it.
To Bran.
Come, Geralt.
Stay and chew the fat with us, Geralt.
Holger, to your health. Especially that black hand.
Now I've a toast. May the Emperor of Nilfgaard's prick stay as soft as a noodle, so there'll be no foul spore to take his place on the throne.
We should go. What?
On a cold, distant shore,
every man on the continent so bloodless.
Yes. Yes.
What did you say? The
gods are not kind, Jarl.
Step aside.
Tell me, Lagos. Why are you sending your vermin to my hands?
Allow me to introduce Geralt of Rivia, a Witcher. Geralt, Jarl Donar and Hinda, and Jarl Madman Lugos.
Calling Lugos a madman's an insult to madmen. He's a common goat fucker.
Call me a goat fucker one more time, and I'll chop off your head, stick it on a pike, and piss down your neck hole.
Enough! Time to settle this. Here and now.
Oh, ha ha ha! Giving me a true freight break now. Shat my best trousers. Put that away before you cut yourself, you cunt.
Settle this outside.
Who the fuck are you to advise me, eh?
Someone with better manners. You insult Bran's memory and Crax's hospitality with this. Emperor would be very pleased to hear you quarrel.
His Imperial Majesty is more than welcome to visit.
Let him sail over here. We ain't afraid of the black ones.
Raiding coastal villages is one thing. Total war with the Empire is another.
Awfully melty, this one. Go stir your cauldron and pierce some boils, witch. Don't talk when you haven't got a fucking clue.
Know what, Lugos? just realized I don't give a damn about your hallowed rules of hospitality.
Finally, some diversion. And here I was ready to puke from all the boredom. Come on, freak. Show us what you're made of.
Move the benches. There's to be some gob-slapping. Show the damn bugger his place. Leave the table.
Spots, room, rocking like a leaky tub in a hurricane.
We'll call it even then, as soon as you apologize to the lady.
Don't hold it against me, m'lady. It's my deep conviction sorceresses are needed, deeply so.
No offense taken. Forget about it.
That's my light. And the knocking. It's what men do. Give me your paw, Witcher. Let me squeeze. It's a worthy one. Witcher, have a drink with me. Proof there's no hard feelings. And visit me at times, I insist. Lauren's been jabbering about bringing in a Witcher for that haunted lighthouse. Do me a favor. Meet him for an ale in the tavern near Arinbjorn. Then you put a short jaunt to find me, so as we can knock back something stronger. Here's to our next.
Sure. I'll knock one back with you, Lugos.
Geralt, I'd have nothing against you drinking yourself stupid if we had nothing important.
Drink like you fight, and we're in for a good time. To Bran!
To Jarl Madman Lugos and his madness. Forgive us. We should mingle, talk to some of the other guests.
Greetings, Geralt.
With Bran gone, by my count, that makes you the eldest of the Jarls.
Aye, it does. But I trust it'll not be for long.
Not like any of the others stand out, age you.
Nay, but I'll gladly pass the honor to the next in line. I've lived my fill, steeped my hand in the blood of foes, felt the warmth of the southern sun and the bite of the northern winds, the touch of women of the east and west. Now, I wish to die a death worthy of song.
What's new on Hindersfjall?
New? Lofoten lies in ruins. The garden has been devastated. And now we must deal with an Ulfhedon. In short, everything's grand.
Farewell.
Well, what is it?
Two clans on one island. Tough to be neighbors so near each other.
A neighbor is one who lives nearby, not one who stole half your home. The Ancrit seized our lands.
In the days of Harold the Cripple. That was 3 centuries ago.
Doesn't change the fact they had no right. I'll rid Ard Skellig of crack and his brood yet.
Farewell, Lugos.
Well, what?
Just out of curiosity, why do they call you Madman?
Yeah! That's what.
Farewell, Lugos.
Feast the character older legendary. Axe tossing, tailed bear,
young rock sellers stacked high with barrels.
What?
He's not
not exaggerating. Hard skelly me. You are take bears and
got a minute. Sad when someone like Bran dies. Everyone says he was a good king.
It's not fitting to speak elsewise about the dead.
Mimi don't agree.
Bran spent his life at sea. And while he was away, old feuds flared, devouring the Isles from the inside. Folk grew furious, claiming there was no one to mediate, resolve quarrels. But then Bran would return with loot, throw a feast, let the mead flow in rivers, and everyone loved him again.
Farewell.
Yes?
What now?
Now we pay a visit to Ermion's laboratory.
Didn't know we'd been invited.
Because we've not been.
Take it, Ermion won't be there.
That's right.
And what's the purpose of this visit?
We're looking for an object. The Mask of Erberos. We'll need it. Come, Geralt.
Now you'll tell me why you need this mask.
Oh, I shall. In due course.
Take it, you'll decide when.
Correct. Hide behind the tapestry.
Sparrows chip, while starlings chirp.
What do jackdaws do?
Jackdaws call. Goldfinches warble, and cranes whoop. Whereas peacocks screech. Hawks scream, larks trill, and doves they coo. That's all of them.
What about nightingales?
All right. Nightingales croon.
That was close.
Yes? Yes?
This'll be tough to open.
Surprises never end. See the ravens?
Hard not to.
Ermion's spies. An indication that we're near his laboratory. I also sense a clear magic in her. Come, there's a ledge outside this window. We must pass along it.
Seen uglier sights in my life.
Geralt of Rivia, being romantic. Amazing how a hobby can render a man mysterious.
I'd want to care more.
Please.
Looks alive. A 100 loose an arrow if he saw that in the woods. Basin of water.
For teleprojection, a reflection of Ermion appears on the surface. Supplicants speak to it. Are you all right?
Cut myself. The door is locked. The animals, they're alive. Yen, watch out. Monsters. What's happening?
You were hallucinating. You ran at Ermion's animals. Sword flailing, I had to calm you.
Must have looked strange.
Your years of vigorous training at Kaer Morhen finally paid off. Bested nearly all the stuffed beasts in here.
Please.
Fine. We've passed the trial of taxidermy. The door stands open. Let's go inside, Geralt.
Had one at Kaer Morhen.
Please. Yes, I'll lock the entrance. We don't want to raise suspicions. Ah, our dear druid's laboratory. We must search it thoroughly. The Mask of Urbaros must be here.
Letter bearing Ermion's seal to the druids.
Wondrous world of insectoids. You. Ritual plants. Ah, what do you know? Raymond Marlowe. A biography enhanced.
Seems Ermion has real tobacco brought in. Skelliger's tales about the Wild Hunt.
The islanders believe the wraiths sail on a longship built of the claws of dead men.
Pinecone. Didn't expect this, a large female. A child's skull. Sword in a stone. Things begging me to pull it out.
It's not in the stone, don't you see? It's held there by a vice.
Laboratory worthy of an imperial alchemist. A goat carved out of lindenwood, signed to Uncle Ermion.
Little Ciri's handiwork. That's what she called him when he was her tutor.
Looks like Ermion places something in the statue's hand. Need something else. Gotta look around. Look at this. A detailed map of the Northern Kingdoms. Even shows spheres of influence over the ages.
Out of date. Ermion's wand. He's one of the few druids to use one.
Goes in for light reading, too. The Corpse of Novigrad by Sasha Hadi. Dwarven Triple Mead. Let's try again. How about a mug of mead? Statue or not, everybody needs a drink sometimes. Huh. Seems like it worked. Who would have thunk?
Ermion enjoys jests achieved at the expense of others. I have a sneaking suspicion the mask will be in here. Geralt, come here. I found the mask. This is it. We've got it. We must return to the feast quickly before... Damn druid will poison us. This vapor's deadly. We've got but a few minutes.
Teleport us out of here.
Think of something. Quickly. First thing to come to your mind. Hold on tight.
There is no greater act of valor than to fight a beast cursed by men and gods. No greater deed than that done to serve the goddess.
Words of uncommon beauty. We thank you. We'll take them to heart. But now, let's begin. We have seen Bran off to the Beyond, and must now choose his successor. The king must be wise. The king must command respect. The king must have bollocks. We've no lack of men like that. Let those who feel worthy of the throne of Skellige step forth. My son could not be here this day. Behold his axe. Behold his will. May the best man, a woman, win! What's got into her?
She's your daughter, is she not?
Now I know why she said she'll sail to speak her of.
Aha! Children!
The older they grow, the more trouble there. Come with me. All the more essential we talk now. How was it, Geralt, when Ciri was nearing womanhood? I remember well her Nan, her mother, what they were like. They say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
Ciri was impossible to control. No telling her what to do. Had to have things her own way almost always. Why do you ask?
No specific reason. She and Ceres, they're of a similar age. But we'll speak of my children later. First, let's speak of yours. Yennefer claims Ciri's in trouble, and you seek her.
That's right.
If you require aid, gold, ships, anything, barely say the word. I'll give you all I can. And I know the lass lives. I'm sure of it. When the blood of Rhiannon's daughters is shed, the sea grows white with fury. I'd mark such a storm.
Magic anomaly on Ord Skellig somehow related to Ciri, or so Yennefer believes.
It's my strong suspicion, but I can only know for certain by examining the site.
I saw the twisted forms, right unnatural. The druids were barely able to contain it. Explain to me, Yennefer, how Ciri might have caused this great catastrophe.
I'm intent on learning that very thing, which I will do as soon as Ermion stops hindering my investigation.
Don't concern yourself with him. Druids have little trust for mages, but Ermion's heart is in the right place. Am I right to assume he does not know you seek Ciri?
It's of no concern to him.
As I thought. At any rate, Ard Skellig's my isle. You've my permission to investigate as you see fit.
Wondering if I should talk to Ermion.
Leave that to me. Go. Seek and find your Cirilla. If any ill befell her here, an Ard Skellig on my watch, I'd never forgive myself.
Thank you.
No need. I swore an oath once. I aim to keep it. Anvol! Tell the druid I must speak to him. At the usual spot. I've one more matter to broach. My children. You remember Hjalmar? Well, he swore an oath to kill the giant of Unthink. Set off and has yet to return. But as Ceres announced, that she's to set off on an adventure of her own. Got it in her head that Udalric is not mad, but cursed.
Can't help wondering. Got no plans to vie for the crown yourself? Think a good number of the Jarls would support you.
A good number? Those opposed would be fierce, rabid. Madman Lugh's would sooner see an Elf Guardian on the throne. Besides, a man should know when to step aside. Hand the tiller to the youth among us.
Giants. They have been extinct for ages. Anyone actually seen the one on Undvik?
Aye. Dozens of refugees have. The giant drove everyone off the isle. I've welcomed what remains of Clan Tordaroch here on Ardskellig.
I heard a rumor that an unnatural frost gripped Undvik before the giant appeared.
It's true. At any rate, Hjalmar decided to kill the giant and give the isle back to its people. A deed worthy of a king, he believes. My son gathered a hearty crew at the new port. They were to sail to Unvik, then travel on foot to Oskar, the village. But that many lads should have killed the giant long ago. Thus, I thought to ask you.
You should start at the new port. Ask around. Hjalmar might have told someone there his plans.
Take it Ceres wants to lift the curse.
There's no curse to speak of. Ceres has decided she must match Hjalmar and sought out a deed worthy of a queen.
Think she might need my help? You did plan to ask me for it. Why?
The thing is, I don't trust Udalric further than I can spit. Ceres won't listen to me, or her brother. Yet confronted by a professional who will explain why she's mistaken, she just might come to her senses. So, yes, I ask that you explain things to her and bring her back.
If either Hjalmar or Ceres need help, I'll help them.
I thank you.
Now that we're done thanking one another, let's get to work. We must determine if Ciri is still on Ardskellig. I'll change into travel attire and find you. Head south. The anomaly we should investigate destroyed a stretch of forest along the shore of the bay. A successful feast on all counts, Quark. I will see you later.